Second game of the night here at MUV Fitness, Silver Lake, Washington, the Spring League. And we got the Night Owls playing a doubleheader tonight. They did beat the Emerald City Legends in the first game, and now they are now ready to play against the Fab Seven. Fab Seven started the season late here. They're military buddies that just came back from deployment. So they got one game under their belt, and this is game two. They are also playing a doubleheader tonight. This is their first game of their doubleheader, and here they go. All right, the ball is in play. Here we go. The Fab Seven, the team I've been waiting to watch. I've been out of town on vacation, and I haven't been able to watch this team play. But here I am, seeing them for the first time. And let me get a couple, let me get another chair for you. You sure? No. Where is that? I see it. And here goes. Whoa, what a play. No good. No call there. Dimitri moving the ball around. Of course, the Fab Seven. I need to get the use of these names over here. Number three, White, he is coming down. You know, military guys, they like to go by their last name, so. I'm a military brat, I know how that is, but White with a three from the outside. Ball moving over into the corner. Nestor wide open, missing it though. And Austin with the rebound. Dante passing it out to White. White taking the three from outside, no good, in and out. Stolen by White. Here he comes. Strong layup. Gets it. 7-3. Moving the ball around. There it goes. Out from the outside. No good. In and out. TJ couldn't get it in the hole. Brings it back out. Over to the corner. TJ going inside, kicks it outside with a slap foul. We'll be taking the ball out of bounds. Easy call when you hear the noise that loud. Inside, good layup there by Seth. Wait, what, why do they have nine? Oh, it's on the opposite side again. Are you doing it? Fix it. Okay. 7-5. There it is. Good jackknife layup by Dante. Over. Stolen. Outside three, no good. Right back. Laying it up strong, no good. Nestor bringing the ball down, passing it back out. Travis bringing the ball out to the open here, into the corner, shot by Seth, missing it. White with the rebound. Good pass inside. Austin, reverse layup. Travis has the ball, back up to Dimitri. Dimitri will take that three. There it is. 11-8 right now, 15 minutes to go. Oh, no good there. Here comes Travis on the break, kicking it out to Dimitri. Back to back. Fifteen minutes to go here in the first half. It's tied up 11-11. Oh, Austin from the outside taking a three. 14-11. Over to the corner, quick pass. Nestor will take it. Good! Back and forth, this game is going. 14 minutes to go, 14-14. Dre with the missed free throw there. And here comes the Night Owls bringing it down. 13 and a half minutes to go here in the first half. The captain goes down the middle, laying it up strong. Wow, Dante, strong layup there, right into the guts of the defense. TJ not happy with that call, which was no call. Travis from the outside hitting a three. 13 minutes to go here. Here comes Dante bringing it down. Now Fab 7 is a brand new team here in the league here at MUV. This is only their second game in the season. They are a group, like I said earlier, military guys that just came back from deployment. And I've told them that, you know, even though they start off late, I'll have them play double headers. I'll have them play on Tuesday and Thursday to be able to catch up with the rest of the league and games played. In this league here, everybody plays seven games before the playoffs. And there you go. What Austin, the one of their bigger players on the team, but he can hit three-pointers. Travis going inside, kick it to the corner. Good. Seth from the corner. Now, you know, there's not a lot of fans that come out here, but I got a couple right here in front of me. And based on the fact that he was clapping for Seth making that shot, you must be fans of Night Owls, huh? So, I haven't seen you guys come down here before.
We were here.
You were here
we were
before?
Here for the playoffs.
Oh, okay. Now, how are you related to the Night Owls?
I'm Travis's sister.
Ah, there you go.
Family affair.
Travis's sister's down here, and of course, they're here supporting the Night Owls. And like I always say, Night Owls is one of my favorite teams to watch. They're a lot of fun. They play well together. The chemistry's there. They played together for almost a decade, probably, right?
So, you'd have to ask her.
Yeah. So I'm going to come over to Travis's sister. she's come down here a few times, right? So now, of course, you've grown up with Travis and you know Travis. Okay, yeah, your oldest sister, okay. So Travis, he's played multiple sports in high school or growing up?
Yeah, he's played basketball, football, baseball. Yep.
Really?
He's an athlete.
Okay. And you guys are from the Northwest?
Yep, we're from Bothell, Kenmore. Yep.
Okay. So also, so Travis actually played over in Bothell High School?
For Inglemore High School.
Oh,
yeah.
Inglemore,
yep.
They've been in the league since I think the beginning from last year, right? And I love the team because they're one of those teams, they come on time, they're always organized, they got their own team uniforms, of course, and they play really well together. As a coach, I really appreciate that.
Uniforms they are.
Yeah. Well, the inside scoop is they want to order new uniforms from me. I do have a connection overseas for uniforms, and I made them for MUV. Some of the teams are starting to want to make their own, so yeah, they'll start coming together.
You guys have music tonight, too.
Yes,
nice.
Yes. So.
Stop.
A cheerleader? Well, there you go. More information is coming out.
I think she did.
Well, that would be next level. Now we have cheerleaders in the house. Travis's sister might make a debut in cheerleading. That'll be fun to see.
No. Travis is gonna be mortified when he hears this.
Oh, okay. So we gotta keep Travis as his focus on the game. He doesn't want to see his sister out there cheerleading for him. But that's good. It's always good to have family come out and support. So like I was saying, it's always great to have family come out and support. You know, when MUV asked me to you know, run this league for them, I envision a league to give a little more value to it. And, you know, you see a lot of games in men's league all over Seattle, but I thought maybe to put it on YouTube on a nightly basis. You know, a lot of guys want to see them play. And then, of course, I love the fact that I can be able to do commentary and be able to do play-by-play. Even the post-game, pre-game interviews are always fun to do, you know.
You interviewed my son. Do you remember my son was here with me and you interviewed him? Or he was in the picture. Remember when Owen was here?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, that's right. Okay. Yeah, so it's always fun to do that kind of stuff. A lot of guys look forward to that. If they're a player of the game or if they're somebody new, I like to interview them, kind of get them to know.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I've had soccer games that were on YouTube tournaments elsewhere, and I still go back once in a while and watch them. You know,
yes.
It's kind of, or show them to other people.
So like I said, it's always great to have some family and friends come out and support. You know, it's one of those things where, you know, players play better sometimes when they got support out there helping out. But I always keep an eye on people around, looking around and coming out and watching. I always wanna kinda get to know them and see who they're connected with. But back to the game here. 9 minutes to go. And it's 29-30. Fab 7, they're a team that I can see. Now, they are missing a couple bigs that played for them last week. And those bigs are from Skagit Valley Community College. You know, off their offseason, they come out and want to, you know, get their run in and be able to stay in shape. But like I said, this league right now is 13 teams. It all started off with 8 teams on Thursday night, and now it has expanded to 13, and we have to expand, of course, to Tuesday night, which was all planned from a year ago. You know, I actually asked the owners if it does expand, what day I would like to have it on, and Tuesday was the day I chose. And here we are a year later, and we are playing Tuesday nights and Thursday nights here. Two to three games on Tuesday, and of course four games here, sometimes five on Thursday. But all these leagues finish up in about 10 weeks. It includes playoffs. Every team gets 7 games each, and of course playoffs, top 8 make it. And it comes down to, of course, 8 teams go to the Final Four, and the Final Four is basically for the winners is a doubleheader. And my Hoppe Bree team has made it to the finals 3 seasons in a row, winning it one time. We are 1-2 this season, but we are just trying to recover from a lot of injuries and things like that. But there we go. Austin with a two-handed dunk in the paint. Oh, strong. Oh, missed the layup. Austin with the reach out with the rebound there. Austin's a very good player. I'm starting to realize this guy can play inside, outside, but he's a strong rebounder, a great presence inside. You know, Dante, when he first told me he was making a team up, you know, being a military brat, playing on military bases all over the States, growing up in New York and in Hawaii. A military bases, you can find a lot of great basketball players. And it's fun to see that I'm able to now host a military team here in the Spring League of MUV Fitness. I'm over here with my buddy, the captain of Will Hoop for Food. Carrie's over here, you know, watching this team. Carrie, you know, we've got the Fab 7 team playing in our league now. You know, they're new. Did you get to see them play last week for the first time?
I saw them a little bit from the Tuesday night video. That's about it.
Okay. Yeah, that's right. They did play Tuesday night. This is only their second game of the Spring League. They will be playing a doubleheader tonight against you guys, correct?
Yeah.
You here a little early to get a little scouting report?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, Carrie and I are two old heads that love basketball. We're gym rats. We play 3-on-3 tournaments together. And just to let you know, Carrie, the 3-on-3 Everett one just popped out. Did you see that?
No, I haven't. What are the dates?
I want to say sometime in July. I think July 12th to the 16th. I'm not sure exactly, but I think I got to double check that. But I think it's sometime in July. We're going to have to put the old man team together again, huh?
Yeah. Old. Yep. Come with an AARP card.
Yep. Wow, outside shot by Travis. You know, this is Night Owl's second game of the night, a back-to-back. I mean, their guys, they're not high school guys anymore. These guys are a little older now, and they're able to pace themselves. You know, the Night Owls every season do well in this league. It just comes down to the playoffs sometimes. A missed shot here and there, a missed rebound, a missed turnover or something that makes the difference. But the Night Owls are always in the mix for sure. They got a foul call there on Fab 7.
That dangerous team. Yeah. Dangerous team.
Now, you know, what you saw on film and what I saw also on film is they had a couple bigs for the 5-7 are not here tonight that play over Skagit Valley over the north side. So those are the two bigs. They're probably 6'5", you know, 6'6", somewhere like there. But they don't have them tonight. But Austin, number 7 over here, he's definitely one of those players. Kind of reminds me of what you have on your team with Samba and TJ. You know, he's able to, you know, play defense on the bigs, and he's actually able to play guard defense too. But, yeah, he just had a two-handed dunk right inside the paint. So he does have athleticism.
We're a bit short-handed tonight. We don't have any bigs tonight. Oh. No Masamba, no Jason.
Oh, really?
And then TJ's still out for a couple more weeks.
Okay, okay.
So we're going to rely on some guard movement, I guess.
Yeah.
Need a couple more guys to give up five more fouls.
Well, you know, Carrie and I are in the same boat. You know, both our teams that's been around since the beginning of this league. You know, it's just a part of basketball. Our, you know, players get injured. You know, availability gets tough. You know, like, I don't know, we talked earlier about it, but I'm not able to have my team ready for tonight. We were supposed to be at a 6 o'clock game. You know, half my team couldn't make it in a sense. We didn't have enough guys. Night Owls were more than willing to come play a back-to-back and fill in that spot. So, you know, this season with 13 teams, Kerry, you know how it is. It's like a shuffle every week trying to get, you know, the teams to be able to fill in a time slot. But it's working so far.
Yeah, if you just get enough games to make playoffs, it'd be good.
Yes.
If you get enough players.
Yes, yes.
So far, injury is a rotational thing.
Yes.
And a foul there, and one. 40-44. Yeah, we got our buddy over there, Anton, enjoying the hype man position over there. He loves it. Doing a great job, boys, with the videos and, of course, hyping up every game over here during the game. It's a lot of fun out here when you come out to Move Fitness to watch a game or even playing it. Yeah, you know, since the debut league last spring, you know, here we are a year later. You see the talent level has kind of jumped up since we started back in last spring.
Yeah, the league's always had good talent. It's just gotten better talent, too. So teams are just getting more and more competitive.
Yeah.
You got to bring it every week.
Yes.
Yeah, like Terry was saying, you know, the teams are, you know, actually, you know, from eight teams that we started with, now we're up to 13. You know, the word's getting around over in Pacific Northwest Ballers YouTube channel. A lot of guys from around Seattle are starting to recognize the talent that's in this league, and they want to come out with their own teams and come out with their own players. And, you know, it just comes down to, you know, the chemistry and being able to see if we can compete at this level against these good teams.
Yeah. The talent, geez. I mean, every team's got some loaded guys. I couldn't tell you who's going to be the winner this year. I think it's going to be a new team.
Oh, definitely. It's, you know, both our teams are kind of struggling with injuries right now. And, you know, we're probably just hoping to get in that top eight with the playoff situation. And you never know, right? Just like, you know, now we're both defending former champions of this league. You winning, of course, in the summertime league. And then I think we pulled one out in the fall league, right? Yeah, this is now the fifth league, the fifth season, if you want to call it. Of course, every season has the league, you know, starting off debut spring league last year, and then summer that you won, and then fall that we won, and then of course, the eighth seed came back and won it all last league in the winter, which is called the Guys. Captain Zay just needed to squeak into the playoffs. Matter of fact, he made it into the playoffs by losing the last game of the season and still making the playoffs as the eighth seed. And running into the number one seed, the Guardians, which is Anton's team, they were undefeated. And of course, Anton's team was depleted with the playoff game. It was tough for them to be able to have to deal with that, but that's men's basketball leagues, right? You know.
We've all been a victim of it.
Yeah.
That's how it goes, but they did move on, and they're a team full of ex-college players that played together in college, AAU, and all those different levels. But they really made a good run there in the last couple weeks for the playoffs.
Well, so far, you know, we got all four heads on the championship Mount Rushmore.
That's right.
Yeah. We got four the carbon separate. Fifth spot here. I think somebody else is going to get a new bud.
So, yeah, when you think about it, you're right. There's four different teams have won this league. And the question is now the first champions debut league was the Christian Faith team. And Christian Faith, of course, a high-level team that Zach Gill actually started probably a decade ago. And, you know, they might be back in this league again. They do play other leagues, and they're a team that they're trying to put together, an ABA team that they've already established. And we'll see if when that league starts up soon to be able to see them with their local players on there. Now, we do have a team in here where some of those players do play on, and that team is called Big B's Bakery. Big B's Bakery, the captain, Keontae Woods, really has put together a good team. They're 2-1 right now. They had a tough loss last week, but they have a bye this week. We'll see them and see how they do as the season goes on. Now, here we go. Start of the second half. Start of the second half here, 44-46. Austin from the outside missing it. Well, here we are. I'm with the Emerald City Legends, a new team put together by Kevin V, and a lot of familiar faces, of course, guys that are probably played ball together over the years. They got a good chemistry involved in this. And of course, somebody I know, Kaz here, connected with Shoreline at one point, and he's finally made it down here to the league and playing. Kaz got that range of long distance and the height that every shot looks like it's going in. Kaz, how do you feel about this league that you've been in? You've been here a couple games now, right?
Yeah, I'm liking it. It's good. It's competition. Like, I like the, it's good competition out here. Good players. Fun, competitive.
Now, of course, you know a couple guys from Shoreline that are playing in the league also, Jalen and AJ. They're playing for the Tormented Souls with Eric Turner over that side. And they're really kind of showing the league they can score. They both scored, I think, 50 in their debuts. And last week was crazy with two guys scoring 50. Are you looking forward to be able to play against your buddies like that?
Yeah, for sure. I love competing with those guys. Those are my guys, so playing against them always fun. So I'm excited to play them for sure.
Now, over here on my right side, I got, of course, Kevin V, captain of his team, had a great game. He really almost brought him back down the stretch there. How do you like your squad there, and what did you see in that game coming down the stretch there?
I really like our team. I feel like we have a balanced team of guards, small forwards, and bigs. We didn't have our full team today, but I feel like we were playing good, but we kind of took our foot off the gas. Like, we would come back, and then we would kind of relax and say, okay, we're good. And then Night Owls capitalized on those moments. I feel like if we kept the pressure on them the whole game, we would have gave ourselves a chance of winning.
Yeah. Now, you know, you got some different new faces, different players from all over. But, you know, your buddy on your right side, Daniel, came in. And now, Daniel, how long have you known your buddies here you're playing with and for basketball-wise? And a little background of your basketball journey.
I've known Kevin the longest. The rest of them, I just met him here. But I've known Kevin since I was a sophomore in high school. And he was eighth grader. I met him at Emerald City. And yeah, that's how we known each other. And then I played AAU growing up, I played for Shortcrest AAU when I was younger, and then I played for Mariner freshman year, freshman team, and then the rest I just played AAU. That's about it.
So there you go. You have it right, Daniel. It got the Mariner connection here, and you know, I'm not from the area. I'm not from Hawaii originally, and I know that in this area, Mariner's got a good tradition of basketball, right? They bring in a lot of good teams over the years, right? Can you name off a couple names that you know of regularly that played in Mariner?
Yeah, when I was in high school, Bayek, Keontae, they were kind of the upperclassmen that were really doing really well. They gave me a lot of advice. They helped me out. Right now, though, they're doing really good, too. Yeah. Right now, the past 3 years, I think one year they went undefeated during the COVID year. They had a couple guys that went on to play, like BJ, he plays at Western. T-John plays at Western. Then they have Nas. Nas is playing at Edmonds right now. They have some other guys, too. Makai, Jalen. Some good guys. I mean, they're doing good.
Yeah. Now we're watching here two teams. Of course, you just lost to the Night Owls. You know, they've always been around for the past year. One of the stronger teams in the league. One of my favorite teams to watch and play. Good chemistry. But I want to talk to you guys about, like, the Fab 7 team over here. They're the military team. I've been waiting for a military team. I'm of course, a military brat growing up and being able to see a military team come in. I know the basketball level they have all over the country with military guys. What do you think about the Fab 7 here? I've seen them for the first time. What about you?
I feel like they got some quick players. I don't really know. I, to be honest, I've been talking to these guys the whole game. I haven't really watched the game.
So, yeah. So, again, with Fab 7 being one of the newer teams in here, they came in a little late because, you know, they were on deployment. Dante called me up, the captain over here, and wanted to play in it real badly and just said, hey, if we can have a couple bye weeks and be able to come in after we get back from deployment. That's why they're kind of a little behind. They are playing a doubleheader tonight to catch up on their games played for the league. Like I said, every team's going to play seven games. We got Nikita's team that's already played six. So
they're playing tonight?
No, not playing tonight. No, I got to have give them a bye next week and then probably play one game the week after that. And by week number seven, have another bye. By week eight, we'll be in the playoffs probably at that point. So we'll see. We'll see how it is. You know, I know they're a bunch of young high school kids, but, you know, I had them on by accident or just by chance. I was able to get them in to fill in on doubleheaders two times. So that's why they have six games already. Now, they are only 3-3 right now. You know, yeah, they're all like, you know, D1 level type guys that probably going to be playing somewhere in college next year. And they kind of don't play much defense. It's like an all-star game playing with them. But once they match up with these better teams here that, you know, put the pressure on defensively, they're going to have to step up.
Yeah, man. I mean, they're tough. Nikita can kind of get to the rim, and he could shoot from the outside. The other guys, too, they're long. So we got to come up with a game plan against them. You know what I mean? I like Keontae's team. And perseverance.
Yeah.
They look good too.
Yeah, all the teams are pretty strong. If you think about the teams across the board, you got the guys, the defending champions, right? The guys are, you know, a bunch of ex-college players that are good. I know Kaz being in the league for the first time, you know, he's probably just getting to know, you know, some of the teams in here. But I'm pretty sure he knows all the players he's seen around Seattle. What are some of the players that you know that play in the league that you're looking forward to matching up with or watching play?
For sure, my guy AJ, Keontae, Destin. That's really all I know. Who I'm excited to play, but yeah. It's a good league. It's competition all around, so you got to come ready to play every night or you could lose.
Yes, and like I said, I was talking to Coach Carey over there. You know, he won the Summer League last year. And then before that was the debut league won by Christian Faith, and then my team won in the fall, and then the guys won in the winter. So there's been four different champions, and I'm pretty much sure there's probably going to be another champion or something here because all 13 teams are capable. It really comes down to keeping healthy and keeping the chemistry together when playoffs comes around.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Yeah, that's what we're focused on, just getting our chemistry together. This is our first time playing together, so once we build our chemistry, I think we got a shot to win it.
Yes, there you go. You heard it from the new team, Emerald City Legends. A bunch of guards, in a sense, that can play both sides of the court and have multiple skill set. They're going to be able to showcase their talent against teams that are veterans in this league and teams that have played ex-college players and overseas players. The league's looking like it's getting stronger and stronger with this Dante going inside. He's one of the highlight reels of this team right now. I was looking forward to watching his team. I like number 7, Austin, the big guy. Do you ever see him? Because I've never seen him.
No, I've never seen him before. But, yeah, he a big presence down there. Big body getting boards. So, yeah. Tough matchup for sure.
Right. And they did have a couple guys last week or Tuesday or that played. They're from Skagit Valley. You know, big 6'6", 6'5 guys that played last year in Skagit. So, you know, if they come back, this team will be a team to reckon with for sure.
Yeah, definitely a team to reckon with. Not bad. Got some nice guards out here, quick. Uh-huh. Some bigs down low, so yeah. Good team.
Yes. Dante taking a shot from the outside. Good. Now, there it is, 58-67. Thanks, guys, for talking with me. We'll see you guys later on next week when you guys play again. You guys are 2-1, 1-2, just like us. Oh, I played high school in Hawaii. I played at Shoreline for 2 years, community college, and then I played at University of Hawaii, and then I played overseas in the Philippines for a short time after that. But I'm a gym rat. I play all over now. I'm 51 now, and Kevin knows I'm one of those older guys that still like to play with the young guys.
Back then it was a whole different story, huh? Back in your days.
Well, at Shoreline where I played, our team wasn't actually good. I do hold a record of 4.2 steals a game with a 6'5 wingspan. I now, at my age, I'm a shooter. But back then, yeah, my defense was a thing, and I just was good with that. But being able to watch and play with these guys, you know, I'm at that mentor stage where I really, you know, Kevin's one of those guys I've known for years, and we talk back and forth basketball, and I've seen him improve over the years. He's one of my favorite players to watch now because he's got that ability to not only score in different ways, but his defense is there, and that's what I like about him.
Yeah, he's all around.
Yeah, yeah, man. And yeah, shout out to Dennis. Dennis really helped me improve my game. I used to just kind of be look to score. Now I kind of
look to lead
and get everybody involved and try to play, keep improving my defense part of the game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, Kaz knows how I am as a coach. When I first met Kevin, I was like in shock because this guy was the most ball dominant guy I've ever seen in the pickup runs. I think it was one of the first times I've seen him at Everett. I didn't say anything for like 8 possessions because he shot every time and didn't pass. And I was like, even though he's capable of doing it, he understands now that sometimes it has to get your teammates involved because you want them to stay focused on defense to help out on that side of it. But Kaz seen me go crazy on guys in the summers, and you know, it's just my passion about the game, and I just want guys to get better. And if they feel that presence from me, they just know how much I passionately love this game and want to see these guys improve on it all the time. Kaz, remember those pandemic days outdoors in the cold, right? We were really loving basketball at that time.
Yeah, it was good basketball back then. But, yeah, I definitely see you get on some guys just being competitive and just trying to see people be better and play up to their capability. So, good basketball mind, always giving back to the kids and trying to see him grow.
Yeah, I always appreciate Kaz, man. He's one of those guys. He's quiet, but he's a killer on the basketball court. You better guard him because he'll hit that shot from any distance. And he's got a crossover that you might get some tape on your ankles because he'll break some ankles out there too. But yeah, that's the fun thing about this league, to be able to kind of come together, talk. And I've always been wanting to put a league like this together where I can put value into it by not only just watching the game, but putting it on YouTube and being able to watch these guys. And I, as a coach, I always focused on saying, guys, if, you know, we think we're better than we are until we start watching each other, ourselves on TV. We start watching ourselves on film and you start realizing we're not as athletic or not as fast or not as quick.
I stopped watching the games because it was too humbling.
Yeah, it was back in probably University of Hawaii. Yeah, definitely overseas. You know, there it's the detail in each and everything that made a difference to realize how important this game is when it comes down to details. So now here we are at a men's league. You know, guys are enjoying to be able to play at a high level and still enjoy what they do. And just looking at the game right now, 8.5 minutes to go, 63-70. Dante on the free throw line. He's like I kind of said when I first watched him play, it was like kind of like Allen Iverson kind of guy in my mind. That's back in my generation. But, you know, he's well known around town. Of course, his teammates here are not as known as well because they are on the military base over at Oak Harbor. But it's always fun. Like I said, I got a Monday, Wednesday, Friday, basically an open run at Mill Creek LA Fitness that I've been kind of organized for over the years. And a lot of guys show up there and compete. But what they like about it is organized. I got a group chat, three different group chats of over 100 something guys to keep track of what's going on around town and what we do at the gym. But it's kind of the feeder to find those diamond in the roughs, right? To be able to kind of say, hey, maybe we can fill them into the league over here or get them into our basketball circle, because the bottom line, we just want to compete as basketball guys and lift that level of basketball, not only on the talent level, but up here in the mind to understand this game.
Yeah, no, I really like the LA Fitness runs because you get to play with different people.
Yeah.
You get to meet new people.
Yeah.
I can't believe the amount of people that I've met.
Yeah.
Like, I would have never met him. I would have never met him if it wasn't for basketball.
Right.
Like, these guys are from different places. Like,
yep.
You know what I mean?
Exactly.
It's crazy.
You know, yeah. I always say that too. You know, in my lifetime, you know, being able to play overseas, meet people from different cultures. The one thing about me is I always try to get to know people outside of basketball, even though we play against each other, to be able to really know these people and where they're from and kind of understand where their journey came from with basketball. So this is the one common denominator we have as basketball buddies is basketball itself. There he is, another buddy of ours that just walked by. He's a regular basketball guy here at MUV, but I think he's coming tonight because he's actually playing with a team tonight. I think he's probably playing with the Val's team. You know, Val and him are good friends, right? Yeah, Ricky. Ricky, I'll be talking to Ricky in a little while. I know Ricky from the AAPBA basketball leagues. He's still one of the younger guys that still plays ball, and now he's out here to kind of showcase his talent out here. Daniel's new to this whole thing. What do you think about the league so far, Daniel?
I like it. I played in the ABBA too, and I think I like playing with this team a little bit more.
Yes.
Yeah.
Now, what he's referring to, the AAPBA league, that's a great league that Ed actually runs over there in Linwood area, Shoreline area. It's got about 5 different divisions with about 8 to 9 different teams. Will the Thrill just walks in. Their team is next. But, going back to AAPBA, it's a well-ran league. And you guys don't know this, but when I first moved here, the AAPBA league was ran by a guy named Manny and now retired and lives in Vegas. And I go to Vegas twice a year to play in his tournament of guys that played overseas in the Philippines that retired. So it's for me, it's a lot of fun. You know, I know I have a good time playing with you guys at your age, but you know me how competitive I am. If I can, I'm a rookie in the 50 and over division, and I want to battle and I want to be able to show those guys I'm still in good shape and I can battle those guys. And there's some good guys out there that played overseas with me that retired in Las Vegas. So we go back and forth with our teams. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah, now it makes sense to me why you go so hard in those runs. You know? But yeah, I think I remember Manny, Filipino guy, right? Yeah, I mean, yeah. That's good, though. I mean, it's to still keep playing. And how do you do over there? Are you one of the better guys?
Oh, yeah. Well, here's the funny story. Me being the rookie of this past season, I played with a Seattle team that we went over there, and we were not considered one of the better teams. But me being kind of the rookie, I was the guy that had to score. I had to shoot. The focal point, I was getting double teamed. By the second half of the first game, I was getting manned, boxing one on me. But I played like 6 games total that weekend. It's tough to do it at my age, but you know, everybody else is my age too over there against that. So we all have to battle. We end up making it to the finals and lost. But the point of the story was, at this age in this bracket, I had an LA guy team and a San Diego guy team come up to me and get my number. And now I'm getting recruited to go play for them across the country and wherever they go. That's what the fun part about it at our leagues.
That's nice.
Yeah.
Yeah. I feel like it's always good to like find a reason to play. Uh-huh. You know, I feel like a big reason why I struggled in college was not having a reason to play. Like, yeah. I felt like I deserved more, or I felt like I should have been somewhere else.
Yep.
And so I didn't take advantage of where I was.
Yep.
So like anybody who's in that same position, wherever they're at, take full advantage of it, because it's gonna turn into something bigger.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah. You know, that's a good point that Kevin made. You know, as a coach, living through the journey of basketball, the one thing I tell I coach the women's program now at Shoreline, did the men's program a few years ago. The one thing I always preach to the guys and the girls is that when you come to practice, just keep this in mind, in your short span of life, the season's only 5 months, and when that's over, that's all you have. So the window of opportunity for that, a chance to make an impression or really put all the effort in, is that small window, because when it's all done and all we have is, you know, the shoulda, coulda, woulda back, you know, in open runs when we're just having fun, right?
Yeah.
So, you know, put all the effort you can when you're playing, put all the effort to get better. Because at the end of the day, you want to say that, you know, you put your 100% in before it ended.
Exactly. Yeah, I feel like it's okay to lose sometimes. You know, it's okay to lose as long as you, like, actually give yourself a chance to win. If you didn't even give yourself a chance to win, then like you said, shoulda, coulda, woulda.
Yes.
You know.
Yes.
If you gave yourself a chance to win, then you could say you won, or you can at least say you're going to get somewhere.
Yep.
If you at least give yourself a chance to get to that high level you want to get to, you're going to land somewhere here.
Yep.
At least.
Yep.
Yeah.
Now, coming back to the game with 1 minute left in the game, I mean, the Night Owls, it's very hard to get play a back-to-back game and then win them both. And it looks like the Night Owls are going to do that tonight with a 10-point lead against the Fab 7. Fab 7 is going to feel that same pressure when they have to play again on a back-to-back tonight, which they will play the Will Hoop for Food team. That's been around. They are former champions. They are injured. They don't have all their players. But again, anything can happen any given night over here in World Fitness Leagues.
Yeah. Yeah. Daniel actually played AU with Masamba and Daniel Gevermichael. Yeah. They played together. Yeah.
Okay.
Fish, tell them the story about Masamba. Was even a basketball player. And how?
Yeah, if it wasn't for me, Masamba would not be playing basketball right now because he didn't even know how to make a layup in seventh grade when I met him. But my coach, my AU coach, he said, "Hey, I see you're friends," because Masamba hasn't grown. He's been over six, because I think he's like 6'4", but he was like 6'3", 6'2", 6'3", in seventh grade. So when the coach said he heard that I had a tall friend, he said, because soccer was his first sport, because he's Gambian, he's from West Africa. So in Africa, soccer is our first sport. And the coach was like, "I don't care if soccer is his first sport. Do whatever you can to bring him to our AAU team.
Yes.
And I said, "All right." So I asked him, "Somebody, you want to come play on our team?" He said, "Nah, I'm a soccer player." And then I told him, "Hey, I'll give you my lunch or something, but come through, just check it out." And then he said, "All right." I gave him my high school lunch. I mean, not high school, middle school lunch. And then from then, he showed up. And then while we're scrimmaging, the coach had him. They had him every day on the sides, just working on layup drills, because he couldn't make layups in the beginning. And then he just got better fast. And ever since then, he just been like one of the star players. He just got hooked. and then he just took over.
Well, there you go. That is the real story behind it. Masamba is only good because of Daniel. Daniel got him on the map of basketball. So for all you out there looking to recruit, Daniel probably got some names he put together in the past. Get you guys some players that he's formed into basketball players from soccer players. Masamba, a soccer player, now a high-level basketball player, actually played at Edmonds Community College. So great.
He got some soccer moves too.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, yeah. He got some soccer moves. Yeah. Okay. Even though he doesn't play anymore, yeah. But yeah. After that, he was on his own. After that, he put in the work.
Yeah.
But like I got him in there by force.
Nice. Well, good talking to you guys here. Let me go do an interview for the games over here, guys. We'll talk to you guys later.
Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 11 to 1. 11 to 1. I get there by 10:30. Kevin knows.
How's it look? So anyway, guys, MUV Fitness, basically, this team here that I have, the Night Owls, and it's very rare that a back-to-back game that a team plays can win both of them. You guys have proven that you guys not only won both games, but you won them pretty convincingly. How do you feel about your team, even though you've already, three, four games in now? How do you feel about your team's chances here in the Spring League with 13 teams?
Oh, man, I mean, we feel great. I mean, we should be undefeated right now, right? That's really what it should be. We took the gas off last week. We talked about it, right? We're coming in here. We're not taking the gas off. It's we're going for the kill every single time here moving forward. So
you got to be ready here.
Yeah.
The thing about the Night Owls, every season they come in strong. They're one of the top teams in the league. And I was saying earlier to the other guys interviewing them, it really, when it comes down to that playoff time, you know, of course, the availability just in case of some injuries, a ball bounces the wrong way. It's crazy how this league comes into play, because you guys were actually, I looked at last season, you guys looked like you were revved up perfectly for the season throughout the playoffs there. Dimitri, you came in late during that time frame and really made a difference for him. What do you think you have now that you have with this squad that can make you guys go all the way?
We just don't have an ego, man. At any given night, you know, any of us could go off. So, really, our offense is not something we ever worry about, because we know that it'll come. Yeah. It's our defense getting stops, you know, hustle plays, the shit that matters, you know.
Yeah.
We lost. We took a tough loss in the playoffs last season, and that's kind of been stuck in our minds. So,
yeah,
it's kind of a revenge season. And then the week before, we lost. We took this, like he said, we took our foot off the gas. And so tonight was just kind of a message and a reminder to ourselves, you know.
Yeah.
Prove to ourselves that we can compete and, you know, be champs in this league.
Right. Now, the captain over here, Seth, you know, he's kind of been the heart and soul of this team. He really gets these guys ready every week. I know he's really serious about basketball. He loves this game. And he really, I can tell by the way these guys look at you, the way these guys play for you, you really put these guys in position to be winners on this team. And you've been with them for a long time, is that correct?
Yeah, oh yeah. I mean, I don't think this is just playing for me. I think we all play for each other. That's what it really comes down to. We all want to win.
Yeah.
And so if I got an off night, if someone makes a turnover, someone, you know, bad shot, we just say, hey, race it, let's just keep moving.
Right.
Next play mentality. And then just go 100% on that one, and that's what we do.
Yeah.
And I think that's what makes us, you know, a little bit different. I mean, we picked up Dimitri, we picked up T,
yeah,
and then we got TJ, Nestor, we got our shooters. We got a good set of players,
yeah,
that know their role,
yeah,
and that's what it's going to take. We're coming.
Yeah, and you guys play tonight with without one of your best defenders, right? Yeah. Eddie's not here, right? And so it was surprising to see how well you guys do. Here's Travis, of course. Travis, one of their sharpshooters on the team. But like I said, this team is well balanced. You guys know how to recruit. You guys put together a good squad. You mentioned T over there. I talked to Dimitri about him earlier. I like his game, and he fits in well with your team for sure, huh?
Oh, just seamless. You know, it's like you plug and play, and he knew exactly what it was coming right into it. I mean, when you set people, you know, putting people that know how to play basketball and play it the right way, nice. It's easy to play.
Yeah.
And that's what we got.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm an Al, but I'll never tell you who.
All right, guys. Thanks a lot. Appreciate you guys. You got to remember that, what he just said. That was funny. So I got Dante, come on over here real quick. Yeah, I got Dante over here. You know, Dante, you know, like I said, you know, this is a guy that, you know, a couple seasons ago, you know, came and showed up and really caught my attention as a coach. I saw his talent, his skill set, and I was like, wow, this guy's got to be in this league somehow. Now, he did tell me you went on deployment for a while.
Yeah.
And you knew you were going to come back with a team here. What was your thought process when you came back?
I had to put a team together to come win. I mean, we're going to be back, though.
Yeah,
we're missing some players, though. We're going to be back.
Yeah.
We're going to get
now,
right.
You do have a couple bigs that you're missing tonight.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, it's a long season. Now, you do have a back-to-back tonight. So you're going to go up against a team that's actually had some injuries, too. They've been around a long time. They're a former championship team. So you guys just have young legs. You guys should be, you know, okay for this game, right?
We're going to be good.
Yeah.
We're going to get back. You know, you lose some, you win some, you lose some.
That's right.
We're going to get
right
this game. We're going to get right.
Now, I want to ask you about your big guy, Austin. I like him. I like him as a coach. As I look at this guy.
Yeah.
Where did you find him? What's his story?
He's in the Navy, too.
Is he in the Navy?
Yeah, we're all in Navy. This whole team right here, we're all in the Navy right here. All of us in the
Navy. I love it. Me being a military brat, I was always hoping and dreaming to have a military team to host, and now I got one in Dante, and Dante's got a good organized team here. That's military style. You got to be organized. You got to have it together, but I appreciate you, brother.
Thank you.
Good luck this game right here coming up, okay?